When it comes to the names of numbers, it's easy to see the naming conventions they follow. And of course, it's pretty important to have these conventions in numbers, as we use them so often and there are just so many of them. And of course, for when we deal with new numbers that we might not have used before. And no, I don't mean like whole new numbers. I mean a number that might not come up often in your life. It makes sense for 0 to 9 to have unique names, as they're the numbers that make up all other numbers, along with suffixes we attach to numbers as they get bigger. But imagine if every number did have a different name, like if they didn't follow the naming conventions that we do have for numbers. We would probably all know the names of a set amount of numbers, but our brains can only hold so much. And of course, numbers with significance in our life, e.g. the number of the house you live at. It would be like trying to know the name of every animal on the planet. In fact, it would probably be way harder. But say if this number had no significance in your life, how would you know its name? And even if you did know it was called Gangagoo, then the number after it would have an entirely different name, like Blimpy Bob. Luckily, however, language and numbers have come together to give us certain conventions, meaning as long as you know the foundations of number names, you can look at more or less any number and know exactly how to say its name, without having to remember every number name in your head. I can look at this string of numbers and know without even thinking it's 37,856. So let's take a deeper look into these naming conventions, how they work, where the names of these numbers come from, and of course, as the title of this video suggests, look at where these conventions don't come into play. First, however, I want to look into the history of these numbers, specifically not so much as to how we say them, but how we write them. The numbers you see now that are used in so many parts of the world are called Hindu Arabic numerals. They're called this as they were pioneered in India, but then came to use in the Arab world, and from the Arab world they entered Europe, where they took over from the clunky Roman numerals, which are now solely used for clocks and Rocky movies. The shapes of these numbers came to be simply through evolution of other number writing systems. A popular theory is that the numbers are drawn the way they are, as each one of them had the same amount of angles as the number it represents. Though this theory seems to be debunked, it's still pretty neat. Anyway, let's get into the name of these numbers, and for now we will be focusing on their English names. This video would be way too long if it covered every number in every language, so to begin with, let's get our base numbers covered, 0 to 9. The names of 1 to 9 as we see them today all evolve from their old English names. And with numbers being such an ancient concept, they don't have particularly interesting etymologies. It's not like 2 is named after an old word for swans, as they look kinda like one. In Old English, 1 to 9 are an, twa, frio, friof, fif, six, sifon, it, and nagan. Clearly, my old English pronunciation is just as good as my modern English pronunciation. 0, however, comes from the French zéro. All of these names for numbers evolved into the names for numbers that we have today. From there, we have the two-digit numbers, starting with 10 and the teen numbers. 10 and the teen suffix are so similar because they basically mean the same thing, with 10 coming from the Old English 10 and teen meaning 10 more than. So understanding this, we can see where the teen numbers get their name. 14 is 10 more than 4, 19 is 10 more than 9, and so on. However, as clear as this is to see with things like 14 and 19, there are a couple of odd ones out, primarily 13 and 15. Why aren't these 3 teen and 5 teen? Well, these current number names are remnants of Old English. We saw that 5 in Old English was 5th, so that's where we get 15 from, and the same goes for 13. These 3 and 5th sounds are also present in 30 and 52, so no need to go over them again. As for a certain other two numbers, we will get onto those later. But as we mentioned 30 and 50, that brings us nicely to our next set of numbers, the ones ending with ty, which just represents 10, unlike teens, which means more than 10, with once again this t suffix come from the Old English tig, so something like 70 simply means 10 lots of 7. However, once again we have an issue, that being 20. Why don't we have 2t? Once again we have our Old English friends to thank for this. Remember how in Old English 2 was twa? Well, that name was a shortening of twigan, where we get 20 from, with 20 in Old English being twentwig. And of course, as we go up, new words get added. Hundreds, thousands, millions, I'm sure you understand. All these names for numbers come from Old English origins too, and aren't the most exciting. What's interesting, however, is a million and its relation to the Latin in mil, which means 1,000. Of course, a million is a whole lot more than 1,000. With all this knowledge, we can understand how to say any number thrown at us, and I understand this isn't the most revolutionary stuff I'm saying to you right now. I'm sure you didn't need a How Numbers Work 101 lecture, but it's interesting to me to see how the everyday things in life work, how we can embed conventions of language into our head so we can figure things out without even thinking about it. However, as great as these conventions with number names are, there will always be the rebel rule breakers. In this case, it is the namesake of this video, that no good 11, and 12 now that I think about it, but just why is 11 not called 1teen is a funner name for this video. So why did these two numbers break away from the convention of language? Why aren't they called 1teen and 2teen? Well, that's because these numbers aren't remnants of Old English, but remnants of Old German, being in Germanic Unlif and Twelif for 11 and 12 respectively. The first parts of those names mean 1 and 2, but what about the lif part? This means to leave slash 1 left. So this means that 11 means 1 left after 10 and 12 means 2 left after 10. This makes sense as 10 has always been seen as a nice round number to count up to, primarily due to the number of fingers we have. So having anything over 10 would be like having spare. So say if you had 11 sheep, it would be easy to see that as having 10 sheep with 1 left over. Same goes for 12. But why did we keep these number names and not change them to 1teen or 2teen? Well, it seems to have a lot to do with the base 12 counting system. So much in life revolves around 12s, the months, the halves of the day. A lot of people even think that we should use a base 12 system of counting as opposed to a base 10 like we do now. Counting up to 12 seems to work so much better for us in so many ways. With a 12 base counting system in mind, it's easy to see why 11 and 12 would gain unique names along with 0 to 10 and not be part of the rest of the conventions. It's just a shame that we never grew an extra pair of fingers. Name Explained depends on awesome people like yourself donating small amounts on a monthly basis to keep the channel running, so thank you to all my patrons who do just that. Donating just $2 a month helps out in a huge way, earns you weekly patron exclusive Name Explained rewards, and gets your name here with all these awesome people. Thank you.